Hello students, welcome to St. Michael's e-learning classes. Today I am here with a new chapter, the first flight. Students, before we start, there are certain things that you have to know. The chapter is about, the story is about self-confidence. The story is about good and bad times. The story is about the stamina that we have. The story is about the power to know our strength. The story is about how much we know about ourselves. The story is about how to take step. And the story above all, the story is about how to terrorize the terror. How to terrorize the terror with your willpower, with the help of your willpower. I have used the word how to terrorize the terror. We are afraid of anything, anybody, me, you or anybody, we are afraid of anything. Till when? Till when? When we face anything, we start terrorizing the thing. Just suppose you are afraid of particular chapter of maths. You are unable to do, you are unable to solve, and you are so much afraid that you left the chapter, which was very important for your exam. And when your teacher told that from that particular chapter, lots of questions are coming there, you will have to score almost 10-15 marks in your board examination, you decided to learn. Although you were not so much good in that particular chapter, but you started studying. You started facing challenges and finally you found that you were able to solve. It was really very simple. It was really very joyful. So this is what the chapter is. How to face the challenges, how to fight with the situation, and how to come out with the flying colors. It's all about our willpower. It's all about our recognition of the power. It's about our self-confidence. It's about a seagull, a type of bird. What happened with it? We will see in the chapter line by line. The young seagull was alone on his ledge. The title, first flight, we will discuss later. The title we will discuss later, students. Let me start. After the completion of the chapter, probably you will understand the title more. You will understand the theme more. Yeah, the young seagull was alone on his ledge. What do you mean by ledge? The meaning is given. It means a narrow shelf beneath a window. A narrow shelf beneath a window or a rock, you can say that is self-projecting from a wall or a cliff. So the seagull was just there alone. What is the reason? His two brothers and sisters had already flown away the day before. Probably his family was residing with him, but now they had already flown away. Only he was left there on the ledge. He had been afraid to fly with them. So here is the reason. Here lies the reason. He was afraid of flying. That's why he didn't fly with his family members, and he was just standing there. He was alone there. Somehow when he had taken a little run forward to the brink. What do you mean by brink? Brink means edge. H-E-D-G-E. Edge means kinara. Okay? So, the brink of the ledge. And attempted. Attempted means what? He tried to flap his wings. He became afraid. What do you mean by flap? Fadfadana. Right? So, it's telling that after seeing his other brother and sisters who were trying to fly, and they flew away also, he also tried. He ran to the edge of the ledge. He ran to the kinara of the lake and he tried to flap his wings to fly. But what happened? He became very much afraid. Wo dar gaya. And what was the reason? The great expanse of sea stretched down beneath. After seeing the vast sea, he became very, very afraid. And it was such a long way down, miles down. So after seeing the great span of the sea, he became afraid. That's why he was unable to fly. It was his fear that has clutched him. That's why I'm telling you students, what we have to do in order to achieve something, that we should have to terrorize the terror that is terrorizing you. We should terrorize the terror that is terrorizing us. उस डर को ही हमें डरा कर भगा देना है जो हमें डराने की कोशिश करता है. दिस इज वॉट आई एम टेलिंग. सो इफ एनी सब्जेक्ट, इन एनी सब्जेक्ट इफ यू हैव प्रॉब्लम, यू हैव टू फेस दैट सब्जेक्ट, यू हैव टू फेस दैट चैप्टर. ओनली देन यू विल नो वॉट इज योर स्ट्रेंथ, वॉट इज योर स्टेमिना, वॉट इज योर पावर. एंड इफ यू आर सेल्फ कॉन्फिडेंट, यू हैव दैट कॉन्फिडेंस दैट आई कैन डू, यस आई कैन डू, यू कैन डू, दैट विल power should be there. So here you find that he became afraid after seeing the sea. He felt certain, certainly sure that his wings would never support him. So he was afraid and he was sure that his wings will not support him and he will not be able to fly. So he bent his head and ran away back to the little hole under the ledge where he slept at night. So finally he withdrew himself. Finally he ran away. He didn't try to fly. Even when each of his brothers and his little sisters, whose wings were far shorter than his own, ran to the brink, flapped their wings and flew away, he failed to muster. Muster means to gather, to collect, jama karna. Muster of courage to take that plunge. Plunge means to jump, which appeared to him so desperate. Desperate means disappointed, distressed. You can say disappointment is there. So he is telling that even his younger brother and sisters, they all flapped their wings. They tried, they flew away, but this one, he didn't try to gather his strength. He had tried to flap his wings, but he didn't try to muster up, to gather his courage, his strength, to take a plunge, to jump in the air and try to fly. And that's why he was feeling desperate. He was really very sad, but in spite of it, he didn't take initiative. He was very afraid of flying. His father and mother had come around scolding to him, Shri. What do you mean by it? That is sharp, unpleasant voice sound. Kadi awaaz mein, tikhi awaaz mein, they just calling him. Upbraiding him. Upbraiding means scolding, threatening to let him starve on his ledge unless he flew away. His parents were giving warning that we will not provide you food even. We will let you to starve. Hum tumhe bhookhe rehne ke liye chhod denge. We will not take care of yours. So you come out. But in spite of it, but for the life of him, he could not. But almost for 24 hours, he was there on the ledge. He didn't want to move because he was afraid for his life. That was 24 hours ago. Since then, nobody had come near him. Means the parents were very much angry with him. His brothers and sisters, they flew away. Nobody was there with him. And the parents were angry, that's why they were not providing him any food. The day before, all day long, he had watched his parents fly about with his brothers and sisters, perfecting them. Perfecting them means making them skilled. उन्हें स्किल बना रहे थे, उन्हें फर्निश कर रहे थे, परफेक्टिंग देम, फर्निश देम इन द आर्ट ऑफ फ्लाइट. ही वॉच्ड हिज पेरेंट्स फॉर हेल्पिंग हिज ब्रदर्स एंड सिस्टर्स हाउ टू फ्लाई, बट ही वाज नॉट रेडी टू फ्लाई, दैट्स व्हाई ही वाज लेफ्ट अलोन देयर टीचिंग देम हाउ टू स्कीम. स्कीम मींस टू मूव लाइटली जस्ट अबाउट द सरफेस, राइट? मीनिंग इज गिवन हियर. To move lightly just above a surface. कैसे move करना है surface के above में? And how to dive for fish? और fish के लिए डुबकी कैसे लगानी है? These all things they were teaching. They were furnishing their children, the mother and father. But this young Shigal, he was the elder one, eldest child. But he was unable to fly. He was afraid of flying. That's why he was just residing there on the ledge. He had in fact seen his older brother catch his first herring and devour. Devour means swallow. Nigal jana, devour that is swallow, or herring that is a soft sea fish hota hai. It's a type of fish. Usne dekha apne brother ko, usne kaise fish ko pakda aur usse nigal liya. Standing on a rock. While his parents circled around, raising a proud cap. That is laughter that is unpleasant in a loud sound. Aur usne dekha, his parents were just having fun, all laughter, after seeing another child who had captured the first fish for the first time by himself. And all the morning, the whole family had walked about on the big plateau, pathar. Midway down the opposite cliff, taunting him. Taunting means what? Tana marna. Taunting him with his carcass. That is, he was such a coward that he was unable to take any initiative. He was unable to fly properly and he was not ready to fly. That's why the parents are scolding him, taunting him, and just persuading him so that he will take initiative to fly. Children, हमने नया chapter आज start किया. His first flight, ये एक शिगल, एक bird के बारे में है जो एक ledge पे अकेला छूट गया है because उसने कोई initiative नहीं लिया उड़ने के लिए. पहली बार उसके parents उसे तैयार करना चाहते थे. उसके ब्रदर एंड सिस्टर्स उससे जो छोटे थे वे उड़ गए, बट ये उड़ने से डरता था, अपनी उड़ान भरने से डरता था, इसलिए यह उड़ नहीं पाया, अकेला छूट गया. उसके पेरेंट्स उसे स्कोल्ड भी करते हैं, इवन ये धमकी भी देते हैं कि हम लोग खाना प्रोवाइड नहीं करेंगे, तुम भूखे रह जाओगे. उसके बावजूद भी वो इतना डरा हुआ है कि वो अपनी जगह को नहीं छोड़ता. वो देखता है कि उसके पेरेंट्स उसके अदर भाई बहन के चारों तरफ किस तरह खुशी से खुशियां मनाते हुए आवाज़ निकाल रहे हैं, उनके पास सारे फन को अपने फन को शो कर रहे हैं, खुशियों को शो कर रहे हैं, क्योंकि उसके भाई ने पहली बार फिश को पकड़ा है जिसे वो एक बार में ही निगल गया. ये भी ऐसा बनना चाहता है. एक बार उसने कोशिश भी की, अपने विंग्स को फ्लैप भी किया, लेकिन डर के कारण वो उसमें सक्सेस नहीं पाया. तो टिल हियर वी हैड कंप्लीटेड स्टूडेंट्स. वी विल मीट टुमॉरो अगेन. वी विल कंटिन्यू विद द सेम चैप्टर. स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू आर डूइंग योर क्वेश्चन आंसर सेशन एंड ऑन व्हाट्सएप आई विल सेंड यू पीडीएफ्स. थैंक यू स्टूडेंट्स. हैव अ नाइस डे.